warning. Despite the subject matter at the focus of these videos, my reviews are not intended for viewers under the age of 13. So if you're not of age, turn off the video now. Are they gone? Great, let's get to the intro already. Over the past few episodes, I've started to notice something rather disheartening about this season of Beast Morphers. In the beginning, I was so happy to learn that both versions of Blaze and Roxy were going to coexist within the cast of this show. There was a lot of story potential for villains knowing everything about two characters that are close to the Rangers. However, with Evox yelling at Blazebot and Roborox in the last episode, I noticed that, while they had a great reintroduction into the series, the two generals are more or less right back where they were last season. The real Blaze and Roxy were phantom written out of this series, and the show keeps pretending that we won't notice, while their villainous counterparts are stuck getting yelled at by Evox and trying to betray Skruzzle. I admit, I could be totally wrong on this point, and Beast Morphers has a plan for all four of these characters, but we're almost at the halfway mark of this season, and the real Blaze and Roxy have been MIA for 4 episodes now. However, this is the 7th episode of the season, and with that title, you know it has to be important to the plot. So let's see if I can get lucky as we look at Power Rangers Beast Morphers Episode 29, Beast King Rampage. The episode opens at the fortress, where Skruzzle puts the finishing touches on a special dart for Evox's super secret evil plan. Evox reveals that during the last episode, he had Nate create a special malware that is now programmed into the dart, saying it will hack into the Ranger's new weapon as soon as the dart touches it. Blazebot and Roborox wonder what the new weapon could be, but Evox says they'll know soon enough, since they'll help in Evox's plan before the Big Bad laughs maniacally as he turns into the Mayor. At Grid Battle Force, General Burke informs the Rangers that he and the Mayor have been working on a top-secret project, but since the Mayor hasn't arrived yet, Burke tries to give the Rangers a sneak peek, but ends up playing an embarrassing video of Ben and Betty trying and failing to execute fighting moves. Eventually, Burke disconnects the camera, saying it's defective, so Ben and Betty leave to fix the camera, and Shaw asks what the secret project could be. Burke reveals that he and the Mayor built a Zord called the Beast X King Zord using Lion DNA, saying the plan is to use a bunch of the Zords to protect the global network of Morphex Towers. The team is understandably pissed that Burke created a Zord without involving GB, but Burke says the Rangers were too busy protecting the city, and that this project has no intention of interfering with their operation.
We even have our own designer. She used to work here. And here she is now with the Mayor.
Hey, Dad. Megan.
Hi, everyone.
Wait. You mean to tell me that this bitch was important the whole time? Kinda makes me feel bad for hating on her introductory episode. Totally thought we'd never see her again. Sorry about that. Anyway, Nate is upset that Burke would hire Megan after she blackmailed Zoe, but that doesn't matter to the Mayor, who says that Megan submitted a good design for the Beast X King Zord. Megan apologizes to Nate and Zoe, saying she knows what she did was wrong, but now she wants to help the Rangers, and of course they don't believe her. Megan goes on with the demonstration, using a special activator to unleash the Zord, and when the Rangers see it, they're in awe of its majesty. However, Blazebot and Roborox are right there as the Zord stops, and stick the dart on it so Megan loses control of the thing. Nate tries to figure out what's going on, only to discover that Megan didn't install a firewall in the Zord, meaning that Evox is now trying to take control of it with a virus. For some reason, only Devin is sent out to hold off the Zord before they can control it again, and after he fails at trying to ride it, he asks Nate for help. Nate discovers footage of the evil dart touching the Zord, and again scolds Megan for not installing a firewall. Nate goes on to say that he might have an idea on what to do before sending Ravi and Steel out in the field, but when Megan wonders if she can help, Nate tells her he'll fix this himself. Nate instructs Ravi and Steel to aim a dish at the Beast X King that will beam new programming into the Zord, and when Megan tries to tell him she can help, he ignores her. Megan then tells Zoe that Nate's plan is going to backfire, but she doesn't believe her, so Megan provides a deeper apology. Megan says she was selfish back back then and hurt a lot of people along the way, but now she's changed and wants to help the Rangers. Zoe absorbs Megan's words, but says she needs to help Nate, before we cut back to the field where Ravi and Steel set up shop for the dish. Zoe tells Devin they need a clear shot, so the Red Racer jumps on the King's back and tries to rein it in. This is enough for Steel to shoot the Zord with the beam, but Nate's program triggers the Zord's battle mode instead of retaking control. Nate tries to figure out what to do now, and Zoe tells him what Megan said about his plan failing. At first, Nate says that Megan caused this problem to begin with, but Zoe says they should put their personal feelings aside and accept her help, and Nate reluctantly agrees. After finding Megan, Nate explains the situation, and Megan tells him that his program didn't work because of an auto-defense mechanism she designed into the Zord. Nate's impressed, but wonders how they can get around Megan's defense, and she says they need something to physically attach to the Zord, like the dart, and Nate says he's been working on something that might help.
This is a prototype of the Ultra Bow.
I see you've put Jackrabbit and Gorilla DNA in it.
Son of a, this bow was important too? The one Nate was working on in the last episode that I didn't show because I figured it wasn't relevant yet? Man, this show is full of all kinds of surprises. While that's going on, Devin is still locked in a tough battle outside and tells the others he's running low on Morph-X. Luckily, Megan uploads Lion DNA into the bow, turning it into the Beast X King Ultra Bow, and as the Rangers head out to help Devin, Nate congratulates Megan on a job well done. The four Rangers make it out on the field, and Nate says they only have one shot at this, which of course is Blazebot and Roborox's cue to show up with Tronix. Ravi tells Nate they'll hold off the baddies while the Gold Rangers takes the shot, and what follows is a pretty kick-ass unmorphed fight. Nate gets into position, telling Devin he needs a clear shot, so the Red Racer and King Zord strike each other in the head at the same time, which stuns the new Zord long enough for Nate to shoot it with the arrow. Devin waits with bated breath, wondering if the arrow worked, and the disappearance of red glowing eyes signal the Beast X King is back under the control of the good guys. This pleases everyone except for the mayor, who leaves disappointed, and after the Red Racer mounts the King Lion again, we return to the ground where Roborox tells Blazebot to deal with the Red Ranger since she can handle the rest of the team. And Blazebot returns in his Zord from the finale that was rebuilt by Scruzzle. The Zord fight is intense for a second before it's revealed the Beast X King has a cycle mode, and on the ground, Roborox is turned into dust by the Beast X King Ultra Bow. Back with Devin, he uses the cycle to knock Blazebot out of the sky, but that uses the remainder of the Red Racer's Morph-X, so Devin jumps into the Beast X King Zord to keep fighting. Devin initiates the Beast X King battle mode, and now the Zord changes like a proper transformer, and I have no idea why I brought that up on a Hasbro production, wink wink nudge nudge, this is awesome. Now that Devin's ready for battle, he beats the ever-loving shit out of Blaze in a fight that's not even close or long, and Devin destroys Bot and Zord easily. After the fight, Ravi examines Evox's dart, saying they need to dispose of it carefully, before he just sets it on a table. Devin thanks Megan for her help, before she gives him the Beast X King Zord activator and key, saying it belongs to the Rangers now. General Burke apologizes for making the Zord without GB's help, but Nate says they were lucky Megan is a top-rate designer and that her help saved the day. Megan thanks everyone for giving her a second chance before Ben and Betty walk in with their dad's repaired camera and immediately start cleaning up the mess in the lab. However, when Ben tries to toss Evox's dart into the trash can, he accidentally hits Steel, which doesn't give us an evil Ranger because only Steel's legs go crazy. I guess they run on a different interface than the rest of his body. Steel detaches his legs, but that doesn't help much since Ben, Betty, and Steel chase after his legs when they run off. And the episode ends with the other Rangers starting to run after the trio, but they end up stopping so they can laugh at the ridiculous situation. Yeah, laugh it up, guys. It's not like this is still a huge problem or anything. This episode is okay. Not great, but still okay. I'll admit that my ranking was tarnished somewhat by that terrible ending. Something that could have been a cool cliffhanger is mocked for an ending joke that shouldn't be as funny to the characters on screen, since this is still a problem. Hell, Nate should be more worried than anyone, given that he just spent the episode creating an antivirus for the malware, plus that's his brother that's now infected. But nope, the goofy music's playing, so everything's fine. It's disappointing because I feel like Evox's super secret evil plan should have a bigger impact than it ultimately does. I mean, seriously, Evox spends episodes on this super secret evil plan, and all it amounts to is turning one Zord sword wild, so it'll attack a random forest outside the city. I get that Evox wanted to make an army of these things under the pretense that they'd be commissioned for protecting the global Morphex towers, but why did he have to show his hand to the Rangers on the prototype by infecting it with Nate's virus? Did he not think this would alert the Rangers to his evil scheme, and now Nate's antivirus will presumably be used on all subsequent models of the Beast X King Zord? I guess he was banking on Nate and Megan not being able to work together to solve this problem, but in that case, he should have done a lot more to divide the two instead of just standing around staring at the monitor. Furthermore, why did Evox need Nate to program a virus in the first place? Scrozzle knows how to do that, so why not just use him? Megan didn't install a firewall, which is likely Evox is doing, so any virus would have accomplished the same thing for the bad guys. I kept expecting there to be some kind of hidden programming in the Zord that would override an antivirus, and that's why Nate had to be used. It would plant the seeds that, while this is a battle won for the Rangers, Evox would ultimately win the war. However, based on how disappointed the mayor was at the Rangers' victory, it's clear this is all he had planned. Congratulations, Beast Morphers, you turned Evox into the fucking Ice King.
Ha ha, Finn! You fell right into for my brilliant plan that I formed out of the thin air like a true magi! Not only did I get you to remove those horrible creatures from my castle, but now you're trapped, and only I can see you. So if you want friends, this is it, pal.
I'm gonna reopen the hole.
No, wait, my plan fell apart!
Other than Ben, Betty, and the villains, this episode is solid. The action is great, and I'm surprised we got an episode that mostly focused on Zord fighting when the Beast X mode episode didn't have a Zord battle at all. The central theme of trust is executed okay, but the big issue I have with it is how we're given no reason to expect this big change from Megan. She was a total bitch in her introductory episode, but now we're just supposed to trust her because she says she wants to help the Rangers. I would have accepted this more if Megan getting fired caused this big character shift for her, but that's never said, so I can't be sure. Overall, this is a decent episode that is an enjoyable watch more than anything else. However, what keeps this episode from being great is how incompetent the villains look, given that this super secret evil plan that was built up for episodes has a very lackluster payoff. That, coupled with a ridiculous ending and a weak character arc for Megan, turned this good episode into just a necessary one. I recommend it, solely on the strength of the Beast X King Zord introduction. I'm Nick, aka Iron Bat 1993, and may the power protect you.